This morning, I declare my topic, showers of blessing. Whether is that why the rain is already pouring on the ground? You know, showers is like a rain, but it's not a physical rain, but a rain of blessing. And if I hear your amen, God will shower it in your house. There shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessings we need. Mercy grow from us are falling, but for the showers we plead. I told you this last Sunday, I'll be last 2 Sundays. I have an assignment to speak to your situation, speak to your hands, speak to everything around you. Now, remember, the world where we are is a product of word, W-O-R-D. And God said, let there be light, and there was. In number 14:28, he said to Israel, whatever I hear you say. So God is controlled by your voice. In John chapter 6:63, Jesus said, the words I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. If you are a child of God, the greatest weapon you have is the word of God. When you understand how to declare it and it begin to happen. And when you know this, I tell you, you'll be mindful of what to say. And be careful what comes out of your mouth. Sit down. I was talking to somebody during the week. They are a member in this house, me and the wife. They had a little delay before they started having children. And one of the child now, that one, thunderstorm. So I was talking to him, I said, God told me one day when I lay hand on your son. Now prayer, you and your wife cried when you were looking for a child. And he admitted and said, it's true. You were telling God, give us children that will scatter this house. This house is too cold. And this one come with anointing. Because everywhere was quiet. He said, Lord, this house is too quiet. Give us children that will scatter this house. Make this house hot. This one came with a thunderstorm. I told him, I said, no, be that boy fault. Now pray away, you and your wife pray, put seed on the altar. Now it come out so. He told me, say, it's not like that. There was a time he was telling God, he said, this house is too cold. And he said, I think the house is hot. Now he said, over hot. Over hot. You see the small boy, if you enter here, you go, no, say, person enter. So you must understand the power that is in your world. And this morning, I am exercising the same authority in your business, positively, in your marriage, in everything around you, that from now to December, there will be a turnaround. If I hear your amen, things will turn around. Hear me, whether there's rain or sun, these 7 weeks, I open every channels of your blessing. Every channels of your blessing that is shut down. If you agree with me, thunder amen is coming up. It's coming up. It's coming up.
Chukuga osaningosi. Osaningosi gina. Mekani webiga oke. Kabon kwanko nyinsopta. Oh, sangozi di anima, tapo kebere di obua, ma osaya di anima.
I pass the creed. Even if there is, because there are some people, they are struggling because somebody shut down against them. Some people trapped, made an evil step against them. I stand on this altar. If there is anybody who locked door against you financially, who locked door against your family, who locked door against you in any direction, somebody holla fire 5 times very loud.
Fire, 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 fire.
Yeah, heard this, I want to hear your voice in this service. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There is power in what you say. Numbers 14:28, God said, as long as I live, whatever I hear you say, that law is still existing today. Your word controls your destiny. Stretch your hand. If they have gone any journey ahead of you, ahead of your children, out of envy, jealousy, to stop you, as you thunder, amen, we terminate that evil mission. Whatever that has covered you financially from any occultic altar, all their mirror, all their sacrifice, somebody had a fire 3 times. I take authority. Every attack against your finance from any occultic altar, from any witchcraft cover, evil sacrifices raised on any altar, on any junction, somebody had a fire 7 times. I pray for somebody some time ago. God told me somebody locked door. Use padlock to lock door against him. Shall the father, any evil padlock locked against my finance in any form, break. Or you pray, evil padlock locked against your finances. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We command Holy Ghost. Now listen, listen. When you are in a service like this, you must say something. There are some people, what is following you forbid you to get results, no matter who pray for you. One day I was ministering in this house and the Lord showed me a man who attended meeting that something followed him for us because he knew that he can be delivered here. And that some of you were in that service. I mentioned where I saw him. The man shouted that he came from all the way from Imo State, carrying stone inside his tummy. And they stayed. They said, no matter where you go, but the Lord opened my eye to it. We have to pray. Shout the Father. Every evil spirit following me against my happiness, I command you. By the power in the name of Jesus, return back to your sender. Or you are commanded now, you spirit of failure. In Jesus' name we pray. Hear this. The greatest attack is not attack against your health, it's attack against your faith and your voice. There are many, when the prayer is going on, they are tired of talking. Because it's a positive talk. The devil will tell you can't stand, you can't pray. But the moment you finish serving, they can sit down and engage you for 3 hours. Talk to me. Stretch your hand. I speak as I am commanded. If there's anywhere they lock you up, they lock up your door, lock up your finance. In the name of Jesus, as you know what, amen, you are liberated. Whatever assigned to follow you, I wish you can turn around and shout fire. Da, 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 da. Whatever assigned from any coven, from any kingdom, from any altar, somebody rise or shout fire. Ya, 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 ya. Whatever they send against your destiny, against your children, against your finance, they say you go touch money today, you can't feed yourself tomorrow. Turn around, roar fire. Ya, 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 ya. Stretch your right hand. I join faith with you. Any altar they will call you, any witchcraft coven, any occultic altar, I command their evil backfire. In the name of Jesus, we forswear their mission. Any one of you, they hold your money, they hold your resources, hold your children's visa, their document, hold their marriage. As you thunder amen 3 times in the name of Jesus, we liberate them. Listen, every opportunity ahead of you that somebody is covering, in the name of Jesus Christ, today we release it now. I pass decree, blessing will flow like a rain. There will be showers of blessing. If I hear amen, it will fall this week. I say showers of blessing. Blessing in form of a rainfall. Uncountable blessing. Somebody hello, I receive it. Now before you sit down, shout the Father. Any man or woman
who vow that I cannot be better than them. Hear you the word of the Lord. Whatever you are using against my destiny is terminated. Or you are declared. Whatever you are using against me and my destiny is canceled. Aha. In Jesus' name. Now listen. This assignment is important. Any corner where they are remoting your finance, they are remoting your life, your happiness. Holy Ghost! You suddenly forgot. Wait. You know why I always wanted to throw that fire in the three corner? There are four cardinal points that control the earth. I'm sure you are aware of that. Any direction the arrow is coming, any angle they are calling your name forever, any angle they are holding your blessing. Holy Ghost! Any altar they raise, wherever they raise it, in any junction, in your village, within the city, where you are, we command Holy Ghost! Now listen, watch. Let me show you the easiest way. You don't need to turn around. Listen. You see the way I'm standing? Holy Ghost. Fire, I turn back. Fire, I turn left. Fire, I turn again. You are taking charge. Wherever there, anybody, anywhere, born of a woman, that is mentioning your name in evil place, in the name of Jesus, we come and Holy Ghost! Now, even in that market where you sell, it's of a truth that today is not market. But go to every market, you must see somebody. Did you hear what I said? And I stand on this altar. Anybody who is waiting the day you will not be around for them to do what they want to do. Whatever they want to keep. Holy Ghost! Switch your hand. You under the sound of my voice. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will not be a casualty. Anything that follow you come to this service and said, no matter how I pray for you for these 7 weeks, that nothing changes. I speak as your pastor. I command your mission. Bow. Let their wickedness consume them. In the name of Jesus. Sit down. Now go back to that Ezekiel 34. From verse 25 we started. Look at the statement in verse 25. And I will make them a covenant of peace. And I will cause the evil beast to cease out of the land. They shall dwell safely. Wherever you find yourself, what do you know what it means? That wilderness is talking about your ugly experience. Now, cannot take your life. But it started with the word, I will make covenant. Hearing this, financial breakthrough does not work outside covenant. God is a covenant-keeping God. And that's why you must not play. Whatever you agree before God you want to do, do it. He said, I will make them a covenant. They will do it safely. Whoever that is, wherever you are now, whoever around you who is not happy to see you standing, who is not happy to see you have peace, maybe because they have what you don't have, or they are in a better position more than you, they want to use power against you. The day they will do that, may they lose what they have. A man sang a song. I made a parable. He said, those who have one thing or the other, taking believing that it's only their hand. He said, let God remove it out of their hand. Let them test what poor man tested. I said, this prayer is strong. Stretch your hand. Look at my prayer. In that market, whoever that does not want to see you around, whoever that is not happy to see God blessing you, whatever step they will take, in the name of Jesus, as you turn that amen in the name of Jesus, we terminate their step. I love the word. They will dwell safely. July to December, You and your family, you are saved. Sit down. I am safe, whatever may betide me in the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand. I am safe, whatever may betide me in the hollow of his hand. God is promising you safety. The book of Proverbs says safety is of the Lord. In the hollow of his hand. In the hollow of his hand, I am safe, whatever may betide me. In the hollow of his hand. Verse 26. He made a statement. He said, I will make them and a place round about heal. What? A blessing. Somebody shout, a blessing. Do you know, I discovered from the word of God, you don't need blessings to become great. Just a blessing. In Malachi, he didn't say, I will give you blessings. I will open my windows of heaven. Malachi chapter 3 verse 10. Look at what he said. He didn't say blessings. Just a blessing. Malachi chapter 3, verse 10. He said, when you bring all your tithe in the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me by this, prove me now, here we says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you what? He used the word, a blessing. He didn't say blessings, he said a blessing. Put it back, media. A blessing. He didn't say blessings. A blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it. That small blessing God will give you. He said your pocket will not be enough. Your bank account will just a blessing.
Onye nwe midi ebube imeluwe chukwu onye ebere onye nso tanka chasima ina di Indonesia.
Now listen, he say he make the place a blessing. So this week, now do you know what it means? That shop where you find yourself that is at the corner, that's where you find yourself. God will make that place a place of business. Yeah. Wherever you are hearing the sound of my voice, wherever you find yourself this week, that is where your blessing will happen. Yeah. And if your amen is the loudest, it will happen there. Yeah. As no man can count the shower numbers of rain that drop on the earth this morning, nobody will be able to count your own blessing. He said, look at that verse 26. Verse 26. And I will cause the shower to come down in his season. And there shall be showers of blessings. In Psalm chapter 1 verse 3. Put Psalm chapter 1 verse 3. Psalm chapter number 1 verse 3. Psalm chapter 1 verse 3. He said, and it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. He said, his leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. I thought you put amen. The economy will not control your pocket. The price of fuel will not control your life. Now watch it. Even as the thing is hard, watch. When God step into your mother, you see some people now who didn't build when fuel, I mean when cement was 2,000. Now it's expensive. You are buying hundreds to build. Because the answer is that the blessing has happened. God have showed up. If you open your hand, say amen, God will show up. And I see people, I hear people asking you already, how? Now when things are hard, he said, when men are cast down, thou shalt say. You see, what you are saying is important. Don't say what you see. Declare what God said. There's no way God said we should say we are stranded. Even when Moses saw the Egyptian and saw the Red Sea, in the midst of that battle, he saw victory. He says, stand still and hold your peace, for the Egyptian whom you see today, you shall see them. He didn't stop there. He said, see the salvation. In the midst of that battle, he declared salvation. So this week, don't ever look at the weather. Don't look at the economy. Don't look at fuel. Look at God. I look at the mountains and he, where cometh my help? My help cometh from God Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth. For he that watcheth over Israel, neither sleep, let us slumber. But as mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord is to his people, even now and forever. Can I hear amen? Now listen. Let me give you 2 points. How to provoke these blessings. Number one. You must not break your covenant with God. You must not break your covenant with God. Those things you have been doing for God, those things you promised to do for him. Psalm 89 verse 34 and 35. Psalm 89 verse 34 and 35. Look at what he said. Psalm 89 verse 34 and 35. He said, my verse 33 first. Medium verse 33. Look at verse 33. He said, loving kindness will I not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. You are too faithful to fail me. You are too faithful to disappoint me. You prove yourself in my life. Lord, I've come to realize you are too faithful to fail me. Very, very important. His faithfulness is always there. In verse 34, he said, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the thing that is gone out of my mouth. So when God says something, he stands for it. And when you are also saying your own thing, don't say it and go back. Those things you do for God, in your giving, continue. Now let me tell you, the secret of financial breakthrough does not come by prayer. He's attached in giving. I've tried the both sides. There was a year before I started this ministry, I did fasting all through the whole year. And I told myself that beginning of that year that I will use prayer, open the heavens for money to begin to manifest. I pray, finish. I dried down. I couldn't see food to complete it. And one day I was asking God, upon this prayer, I pray for the whole year, fasting. A man of God even saw me say, my brother, he's like, you're on long fasting. I said, he said, stop. Before you kill yourself. I said, why? He said, all the whole bones within your face don't come out. And I told him, he's a man of God, he's a pastor. I said, sir, I am praying to break the chain of hardship on me. He laughed. He said, see, by fasting. I said, what else? He said, don't be fasting, my brother. Learn to give. I said, wait till I get one give. Now pray and now one give. So he said, stop. He said, go and look your face. You know they look face? I said, I know get mirror. He said that is to say your problem is serious. To the extent you can't afford mirror. I said, I know the look. And the truth was that the more I prayed, that day I couldn't forget it. The man dashed me 1,000 naira to go and eat. He said, go break your fasting today. Don't continue. And it was serious. So he now began to tell me implication of what I was doing. And today I have seen some people who went through such things and the thing took their life. Because you fasted out of control. In fact, you lack wisdom in the midst of your fasting. I said, I go fast through the whole year. Money will come by force. So the following year, when I asked God, what do I do? He said, I should pay tithe in the hand of my pastor. Telling, he said, first of all, God said, I should tell him how much I need. I told him, God said, I should take the tithe to give my pastor. I've shared that testimony to give you. And I asked God, I said, is it not the tithe of money you receive that you give? Is it the one that you are hoping? He said, that's the only way to provoke it, because my ground is already dried. I was looking for 12,000 to start business. 12,000. 12,000 was a big money then for what I want to do. And the little money I have. Not if it didn't start. I have 5,000. I told you, it was during any season like this. Because you know, Wednesday prayer is 6 years ahead of this ministry. So after Wednesday prayer, a woman walked to me and said the husband doesn't take care of him, her and the children. That she needed like 1,000 or 2,000 to start come business that time. That will help her with other things and take care of her home. Hence, the husband is not helping. Because the husband is those kind of men who gets more money. They will go and do poo. How enter beer parlor. You know, some of them still there today. Anytime their wife asks, they say, I don't get money. But go be pool. He will tell you, say, he just stay there. He just stay there, they look. The little money would have taken home. You take it to go and mark bad. And the thing badrize you. If you drink, finish, come back. If you want, as I say, if they, you know, they drink, where they dash me. Those who they dash you drink, they know they dash you money. Me, I don't know. So I helped the woman because I prayed. I have 5,000 looking for 12,000 or anybody who add to it for it to complete. And I heard God said, settle her with 2,000. If I give her 2,000, how much remain? I said, so after Wednesday, I joined hand, I pray for her. I said, the Lord answer, the Lord favor you in Jesus' name. And she left. When I got home, my peace disappeared. God said, I told you what to do. I said, now who get money? They give money. Oh, me, I no get, and they dash people money. You know, that is a mentality of ordinary man. Now who to get? I heard one man, woman from New Benin, they say, how can you carry water from Oba River? Go to put for River Niger. Human wisdom. So that night I prayed and prayed. In fact, it's like my heaven locked up. I hear God keep telling me, say, do what I told you first. Hi. So the next day I saw her. She live around Kosten. I called her, I gave her the 2,000. She wanted me to begin. I said, come out. Don't greet me. I was angry. And I said, Pastor, which one? Your voice is harsh. You gave me something. Will I not? I said, no, thank me. Don't thank me. Because I didn't give you because I get. Now the thing dealing with me that I'm trying to obey. Oh, you didn't hear me. So she wanted to insist on greeting me. I walk away. So he said, no verse now. But greeting is not a bad thing because you did good thing for me. I did give you, say I get. I just only give you because God said I should give you. You know what God told me? God told me, said, because when I insisted, God said, look at it now. Assuming, look at it, that two of you are on a line asking for help. And now you have helped him. How many, who next? I say is me. He says, solve his own, solve her own. Then I will not know how to sort you out. And I gave her. When I finished giving to her, God said, go and pay tithe of 12,000. Out of the 3,000, where the men know. I want to show you some formula we don't like. Many of us, we don't like it. But that is the rule. That is the rule. I say tithe, money one I never get. The small one, they say a bird at hand is better than the million in the bush. I was using natural words and natural wisdom to compare God. So after much argument, I now noticed that's what I need to do. But in my own sense, I thought that in the moment I paid that tithe, blah, money will show up. I paid 1,200, remaining 800, and I was thinking that money will come. I finished the money. Nothing came out. One mind was asking me like, are you sure it's God that told you to pay? Or you just on your own? Hi, I was confused. I said, I've been a God. Or I was confused. Because now I was left with nothing. Even to feed myself, I was stranded. And I was calculating, I gave that woman 2,000. I gave tithe 1,003. If I put that money 3,002. But when I heard God said, if you believe you did it for me, why not wait for me? My Sophia not, your leader knows the way. My Sophia not, your leader knows the way. You know, most times we want it as we drop it immediately. God bring it out immediately. There are some people, their own happen like that, but most times it's not that way. That Friday hunger mammoth me that I could not even stand with my leg. Let me tell you, if you have money in your pocket, hunger will not deal with you much. Oh, you didn't know. Many great men who God bless, at times some of them eat once a day and they call it watching weight. But when poor man eats once a day, go tell you say na hunger. Oh, you didn't hear me. I'm telling you, there are so many great men today, they eat once. They tell you say they are working on their weight. It's good for their health. They eat food for the remaining. But poor man will tell you say, they are hardship. And the truth is that that time you don't have food, the way hunger will be dealing with you. That Friday, Saturday, Friday on was 0:00. Early morning, somebody was looking for me. I couldn't stand from bed. I heard one girl, they call Ada. Ada was like, Pastor is inside, telling somebody. I pretend I was not inside because I can't even, my leg couldn't carry me. I was like, how am I going to cancel somebody, me that need canceling? So I heard the small girl. Then I was in Upper one day. The small girl was using her back. You know, she said, Pastor is inside this. I said, before you go pull somebody door, I have to go and repair for order. I said, Ada, he told the man. He's the one talking inside. He told that God he used. That was those days they normally do environmental. So I came out, I saw the man. He said, he used to call me fire. When he called fire, I said, there's no fire today. Because I wasn't seeing clear. Man, who never eats is on Friday. Today is Saturday. And there's no hope anywhere. Thunder, fire, devil. Now, did you know? When he saw, he not say, it's like you came from all night. I kept quiet. He said, I don't want to say anything. He said, I have been thinking on what to do. God told me to bless you. He not gave me black rubber bag. He said, pray for me. He didn't say anything. I said, now bread you bought for me, I did eat bread. If not cloth, you know my size. I said, Father, bless him. And the rubber bag was like, while I was praying, you style it, do daily. And the bag opened mouth, I saw it was currency. Men and brethren, the kind of strength that came upon me, I burst into a man. Da, 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 da. So I prayed for him. The man left. Listen, I'm telling you, life testimony of my life. And the man left. I saw, you know, 200, then they bound it to 2,000. That's 10,000 now. Eh? Is it 29 now? You know, then now, they bound it 5 bundles together, which is 10,000. Then 15 other, one bundle, making 15,000. When he left, I tear that one, we buy bank band 10,000 together. I arranged them for ground. I locked the door well. This is a man who couldn't pray in the morning, though. Strength came. I go wear my shoe. As I would tread upon serpent that's got the money, you don't suffer me. I begin to climb the money. Men and brethren, I prayed for more than 2 hours with joy. Scattered the money everywhere in the house. But you that is hungry, why not take money, go and eat first? I never remember that I never eat since. I remember one parable my grandmother told me, say, hunger forbids a man who don't have money in his pocket. I'm telling you. And at last, I discovered I gave for 12,000 and I got 15,000. And when I knelt down to pray, God said, do you understand the formula now? By strength shall no man prevail. Stretch your hand and pray for you. This week, may you never lock yourself. May you never be the one holding yourself. Let me tell you, since after that, my mentality of tithe and offering. You know, Malachi 3:10, he said, in verse 9, sorry, he said, wherein have you not? He said, your tithe and your offering. And Luke said, the measure you gave is the same measure that will return. So you see that formula. If you refuse to give well, you remain here. You are not above your giving. Oh, you didn't hear me. But the way you give to men, even at times some people want to help people, you give them 5 naira. That when you go with times 5 naira, times 10, give. Cause men to give you also back. Whether you put it in offering or you help people. Hear me. If I want to help you, I will help you the way I wish you help me. Because Bible says, Matthew chapter 7 verse 12, whatever you wish men to do to you, do it back to others. You want to dash people cloth. Now your wash cloth where you are looking for dustbin because you are afraid to pay people who will help you to go and put it in dustbin. You are not dashing them and they are thanking you. Didn't say you help them. And meanwhile, soap have finished the cloth. They have changed from blue to sky blue. Your koiko shoe where he don't break, finish. Where don't bend, go one side. You dash somebody. God will still give you koiko shoe where no get healed. Oh, you didn't hear me. You gave somebody food, now soured food. And he said, just give them food. God will give you the one that have soured food with pepper. God, they measure. Matthew 7, 12, he said, the measure you met, the same measure will return. Luke 7, he said, give and it shall be given. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together. Shall he curse men? So God know the measure you met. And that's the measure you curse men. Oh, you didn't hear me. That's why if God bless you, learn how to advance your giving. Both giving to God and giving to men. Have you ever thought of your life buying car, dashing somebody? Have you ever thought of your life that a time shall come, you build for widows, you give people scholarship. And let me challenge you in this house. God have raised you as a multimillionaire. How many people are you paying school fees for every time? You are not doing it because you want to win election. You are doing it. That's how to spread your net so that heaven can bless you more. There are people you reach out to. It will be impossible for you to go down. Oh, you didn't hear me. When you are there, he said, you know, God said in Isaiah, Psalm 68, he said, I am husband to a father to the fatherless, a husband to widow. You know what it means? If you see widows and orphans and become a blessing to them, God will use you as their father and begin to supply for you. In Proverbs, he said, he that give to the poor, lend to the Lord. You didn't hear this. You are rich, you are wealthy. You never give anybody scholarship. You never pay anybody school fees. Not only you and your children. It's a selfish blessing. You will not like it. Me, your pastor, it's only my peer that know. Both in this city and my village, people I'm paying. There are some of them, I don't know them. I'm paying their school fees. Not because I'm looking for who to help. That's the only way to, you know, connect God. Everywhere is quiet. Stretch your hand and pray for you. May you never limit yourself. Even tithe, so I'm going to tell you, I want to pay tithe. Come pay school people. Hear me. You don't know the seed that will raise you. You know, when you go home, look at Ecclesiastes chapter 11. He said, cast your bread in the morning. Cast it, because you never know the one that will survive. There are seed that doesn't last, and there are seed that stay generations. Since I'm young, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Neither they are seen begging for bread. Stretch your hand. May your yesterday never be better than your tomorrow. I wish you can rise up, say amen 3 times. Amen. Sit down. Let me give you point 2, then I'm done. Are you there with me? Point 2. Work hard. Tell your neighbor, work hard. Now let me tell you, or let me put it this way, work hard and be contented. Did you hear what I said? Tell your neighbor, work hard and be contented. You know, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6 says, godliness with contentment is a great thing. Do you know what it means? I am wearing slippers and you are wearing golden shoes. I'm not intimidated. I don't want to maneuver to get what you have. I am waiting for my time. I wear my slippers, I come to church, I'm dancing, I'm happy with you. Not because I love poverty. No, I am waiting for my time. He's a time setter. He makes all things beautiful. His time. I am working hard and I'm waiting. I am also contented with what I have. Because the worst thing I have seen in the house of God, you don't have money for gold issue, but you want to have gold issue, my dear. You remain poor and become disgraced. Oh, you didn't hear me. These are one of the things God did for me as I start this ministry. I know they look anybody. I face my direction. Because I know everybody has his time. From beginning of this church till now, church never pay my rent for once. One asked me, say, why church you know they pay your rent? I say, if I am not, when I was not a pastor, who they pay my rent? He said, it's the other church. I say, well, here, I don't want it. I know some of you would have also helped me. Okay, if you help me, the day you know, come get what happened. You'll be stranded, I'll be stranded. So let me plan my life. So I told them in this, I'll sew your clothes according to your material, not your size. Sew your cloth according to the material available. If now quarter day, sew tapas, wait for the main time. When the full time will come, You sew your size. Sew your cloth according to your size. Not when you get material, will reach your size. Am I making sense here? I know some pastors. That's why you see, since of this ministry gather, I never do program and say, these are my friends, I gather them. No, I face my direction because I have friends at early stage, but their life was a threat to what I believe. And Bible says, evil communication, cut off good manner. I have friends that time, they will go and borrow, buy clothes, credit, dress, wear Italian suit, credit, buy shoe, credit. When they with the waka, my own, here, so. My own go be like Korombobra. At times they're going to mock me and say, this suit. When we are, one day God said, if you don't leave these people, grace will leave you. It was at last I discovered that we are owing everywhere. Christmas, they'll buy fowl credit, buy rice credit. In their house, they are celebrating. Me, I know buy, they die of hunger. If I go there and say, hey, see my mate, my dear, never jealous anybody because you don't know the source of their blessing. Oh, can I preach here? Can I preach it here? See cloth waiter. You know whether I credit? See gele. See Italian shoe, my mate. Now the same tomato business will they do. At times you go home, you go face your husband. Carry fire giver. See that one. And some of them will tell you, like saying, my husband, though, he gave me 100,000. You go to look, the husband will not get 100,000 for shop. Bring 100,000, take buy only cloth. Are you listening? Be yourself. I let them. I tell you, some of them borrowed money from people I even introduced to them. At last, when they couldn't pay. You know, Bible says, if you don't find out your sin, one day your sin will find you out. Do you know? The people, because I am the one I introduced them, was telling me that this is your friend you brought to me. Borrowed 20,000, borrowed 10,000, buy suit credit. I said, he, those fine suit. Me, I sold my own for Opalawani. And I told you the man who sold my trousers one day that I was disappointed. If I stand like this, it'd be like scared. If I'm standing, I have to open leg. Though your beginning may be small, you are permitted to start beginning, but you can't end small. I mean, you are permitted to start small, but you can't end small. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Who want to laugh you? Let them laugh you. Be yourself. Let me tell you, Remite, it's an error to buy clothes, credit. They dress well, come church. After you wear finish, you will see the person you dodge. You will see call, you are dodging calls. It's not a good life. Igbo people, they call him Ochonganoko. Christmas, you go buy two fowl credit, not one. No. If you go and do our, you see brother, where they say go, to go say, we need go for Christmas, to go pay after Christmas. You go here, they say rice. They say, please, I need a bag of rice. Who see you when you come back from market? Go say, see, brother, we get money. Shish, you no pay. After Christmas, your joy will disappear. When you see fire run come out, you go, remember, say, remember, it resembles the one where you buy credit. When you see some sister for church, you go to do like this, like say, the camera, they dodge. Somebody holler, fire! Yes, that's my joy today. I have some people who have been in Wednesday prayer. You know, this year, Wednesday prayer will be about 27 years. Check anybody. I have never gone to anybody. Borrow me. Not that things were okay. Very hard. But I am contented. My dear 99, there's a man I delivered that was in government in this city. I never go to him to beg him. That's the one I pray for. And before my presence, he gave me tie. Gave his pastor. Check. Now I can't come out. I said, I'll wait for my time. But I was the one who delivered him on poison he carried for 12 years. But I never go to his house. That was the last. God said, you have finished your assignment here. Go back. Wait till your cloud full. Do not laugh at me. God is working in my life. Give me some time. He will be true with me. For they that laugh at me, they will join me to praise the Lord. Sit down, sit down. Walk out. That little thing God put in your hand, walk out. Walk it out. That man you see that is great today started small. Behind every glory, there is story. Manage your own story well. Let it produce glory. Don't be in a hurry. Don't be in a hurry. Somebody riding car, they hungry you. And bicycle, money you don't get. That's why you see, hear me. I told you this hour that every good borrower, those who buy credit, they are good liars. Because they must use something to confuse you and convince you before you release the credit. Or you buy, or you borrow the money. How can you borrow money for Christmas? If you, how many Christmases you want to borrow? The one of last year don't finish. Another Christmas I don't set. Chicken credit. Christmas, children Christmas cloth, credit. Bag of rice way back, credit. Coke and Fanta way they share, they give the whole house like say you win lottery, credit. When the hell he say, brother, they try. He said, God say give. That one not be giving. Now foolishness. Some people are even living in a house that is bigger than their income. If rent to finish, your blood pressure will go high. 2 months to go to the new rent. You know they get yourself again. They check BP every day. When I started this ministry, I'm living 1.5 room. I told you. 1 room, they this way, the other side, Nakiri. Some of my family, the people who live in the same house, some of them are working in this house. They know what I'm saying. If I'm saying it, I'm making it up. Today, Nadia is still there. Tell your neighbor, wait for your time. Work hard and be what? Contented. Mama, you all this Italian women club when you never reach Lagos. Radao. UK women club. United States women club. Wait till they say, na pepe. Every day you type blue gele or purple gele. At times you have to go and borrow cloth to measure up. Check women who live such life, there's no peace in their marriage. Because they will tie gele, when they come back, their house will scatter. Tomorrow they go buy purple judge. Tomorrow they buy blue judge. You are buying all because you want to measure up. Well, how much is your income? How much is your capital? Less than 50,000. Go New Benin. You don't buy New Benin finish now. Ekosai they buy now. Am I preaching here? God, they worry you for village. I'm delivering you to do. This is the kind of deliverance you need. And this, some marriages have scattered because of this. You got to tell your husband, I say, see my mate, where married? Who be your mate? Even if mama born twins, two of them did not come out once. Be like a young girl, you want to begin to dress like first lady. You want to dress like daughter of governor. It's either you become an hand robber or Yahoo or a harlot to make it up. Godliness with contentment is a great gain. But the other part of it is work hard. That little thing in your hand, don't be ashamed. If not clean, not clean well. At times, the one error I have seen, some people are doing something, but they are ashamed of what they are doing, that is putting food on their table. You are a fool. You see some people, you go wrong. Maybe no, say they clean. Look at you. Big fool. You don't even know whether that is where you meet your helper. I've seen some people, it was a place of little job. They made it to the man who promoted them. Maybe no, say at the hawk. There are some people who they do keke business. They ride keke. Instead of riding for permission, they ride for main gate. So that people within the environment will not know they say they ride keke. No, you they punish yourself. If you finish work 10 o'clock, you go enter road, begin come up permission. She, 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 she. Am I talking here? Anyway, rise up. Even some men refuse to do anything because business finished. Your wife be telling you, do something. Let's eat. He say, help me. He help me. You know who I be before? An importer. Before. Now, uncle. My Bible says, whatever your hand finds to do. If importation failed, keke, ride keke, feed the children. That's why you see some men become full-time house men. You know, they have full-time house wife. They still have full-time house men. He's waiting for a pilot work. And he don't have anybody for government for Nigeria now.
You believe, say you are an engineer that will be used to tie roads. Who do you have in government? Nobody. You are carrying file every day. Suit don't finish. All your suit don't wash. My dear, look for something small. Because you know one thing about children. Children will not hear saying a file will work up and down. They'll tell you, say, Daddy, hunger, hunger. Oh, am I preaching here today? Stand to your feet, lift up your hand. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. By faith on earth, whose able land, a higher plan than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Lift up your hand, tell God, whatever that is standing against me, let that yoke be broken today. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. By faith on earth, whose able are higher plan than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on her. In Jesus' name. Now shout it very loud and clear. Shout it, my Father, my Maker. In the name of Jesus. As I follow your word, I will never be stranded. Every limitation before me right now, break. Or you pray. Command doors to open. Doors that are shut against you, let it be open right now. Usebola, a higher plan than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Swear your two hands. This week, as you follow God's instruction, as you're obedient to his word, you watching me there, you will not return empty. May God shower you blessing in every area. Every door closed against you, as you turn that M and 3, then let that door be open. Any form of attack against your finance, against your health, in the name of Jesus, be free right now. Be free right now. Be free right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Another amen. The loudest. Celebrate God with your hands as you take your seat.